You are listening to the Faith Fight Podcast. Today's episode is on overcoming addictions. Hello again, everybody. Welcome into this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and I'm grateful that you took time out of your day to listen to this episode, and I pray it blesses you. I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you, to grow from glory to glory, and ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. And today we are going to talk about overcoming addictions. Now in 2 Corinthians 12 verse 7, Paul talks about a thorn in his flesh. Now though we don't know exactly what that thorn was, any Christian who has struggled with being addicted to anything can relate to having a thorn in their flesh. It could be smoking, pornography, sexual addictions, drinking, or drugs. It doesn't matter how strong the addiction is, the power of God is able to break that stronghold of those addictions off of your life. We're going to look into some verses from the Bible today in this episode that will help you to break those addictions. So if you know anyone that needs help breaking any addiction that they have in their lives, share this episode with them so that they can listen, apply the verses, pray these verses over themselves, and break these strongholds over their lives. And if you have not subscribed, make sure that you subscribe to the podcast so you can get every episode that I release on a Monday morning. And also, I want to remind you that I've created a customized prayer plan specifically for this episode. You can get it by clicking the link in the description, entering your email address, and then you'll be able to download the customized prayer plan. And with it, you will have the verses that I used, the notes that I went over as well, and you can use this prayer plan during your daily devotionals to help fortify and encourage yourself as you do your daily devotions. So let's get straight into this episode. The first verse that I'm going to go over is 1 Corinthians 10, verses 12 to 13. It says, "So if you think you are standing firm, be careful that you do not fall. No temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind. And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out of escape so that you can endure it." So no temptation will overpower you because Christians are no longer slaves to sin. We have the freedom to choose what is good. In addition to this, God is faithful to provide us with a way of escape out of the temptation and give us the strength to say no to sinful enticements. So through the power of the Holy Spirit, we have the ability to withstand the temptation and pass the test. So remember this the next time that you are tempted. Next, I'm going to read 1 John 2, verse 16. It says, "For everything in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life comes not from the Father, but from the world." So the world promises to satisfy legitimate desires in illegitimate ways through the lust of the eyes. Secondly, the world tempts your mind through what your eyes can see. And thirdly, the desires to live and impress others with what you have. Now, if you want to break an addiction to anything, you have to be watchful of what you are allowing into your eyes, what you are thinking about, and how you see yourself, because these can greatly determine how addicted you are to anything. Next, I'm going to read 1 Corinthians 15, verse 33. It says, "Do not be misled. Bad company corrupts good character." Now, the Corinthian believers needed to stop hanging out with those who were promoting false doctrine, denying the resurrection, and living a sinful lifestyle. You cannot make unbelievers your consistent, intimate companions and think that you will continue to live a Christian life without carrying on some of their tendencies. If you are struggling with breaking any addictions of any kind, look closely to who you are hanging out with. More than likely, the things that you are struggling with are the same things that they are struggling with as well. And this is why this verse says, "Bad company corrupts good character." Next, we're going to read James 4, verse 7. It says, "Submit yourselves then to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you." All right, so submitting to God is to recognize your weakness and to stop fighting and surrendering to God as your final authority. Satan has been practicing his craft for thousands of years, and there is only one way to resist him. And it's the same way that Jesus resisted him in Matthew 4 verses 1 to 11. Stop trying to win the battle over your addiction by yourself. Submit to God and resist the devil. And as I just mentioned, I'm going to go next to Matthew 4 verses 1 to 4. This is what it says. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter came to him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." So Jesus used the written word to deal with the enemy. This is one of the reasons why we have the Bible, so that we can remember the scriptures and speak them when we face troubles or temptations. Before the next time you feel pressured to give in to a negative addiction, plant some Bible verses in your heart and commit them to memory so that you can speak them out loud when you need them. They will give you the strength in your spirit to resist any temptation and overcome any pressure from any addiction that you may be facing at that time. This is why reading your Bible regularly is extremely important. Next, I'm going to read Matthew 26:41. It says, "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Now, I include this verse in this episode because we need a reminder to watch out what we are doing and where we are going. If we know that we're going to go to a certain place or hang out with certain people that will cause us to sin and fall back into addictive habits, then pray that God will direct you away from those situations. Your flesh is weak. Don't think that you will be able to use willpower to overcome a temptation when you walk into a situation that is not in your favor to overcome. Next, I'll read Matthew 11:28-30. It says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke on you and learn of me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." To rest means to put your burdens in God's hands and enjoy his provision of forgiveness and eternal life. Jesus did not say that you wouldn't have burdens anymore, but he did promise that it will be lighter if you yoke yourself to him. Next, I'm going to read Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. It says, "When an impure spirit comes out of a person, it goes through arid places seeking rest and does not find it. Then it says, I'll return to the house I left. When it arrives, it finds the house unoccupied, swept clean, and put in order. Then it goes and takes with it seven other spirits more wicked than itself, and they go in and live there. And the final condition of that person is worse than the first. That is how it will be for this wicked generation." Now, if you try to clean up your life with self-righteousness or religious activities, you will only make yourself worse. Without submission to the Lord and the presence of the Holy Spirit to fill the void, you are simply opening up yourself to greater demonic influences. This is why we need to stay in the Word, stay connected to a church, and serve and allow God to fill us with His Holy Spirit regularly. Every single day, pray and ask God to fill you with His Holy Spirit. And now it's time for a moment of prayer. So if you're doing anything that requires your direct attention, please keep your eyes open. But you can listen to me as I pray and agree by saying amen. So Father, we just want to thank you right now. We give you the glory, the honor, and the praise that we can come before your glorious, wonderful presence by the blood of our Savior, Jesus Christ. We thank you that we are saved. We thank you that we are redeemed. We thank you that you loved us, Lord God. Loved us enough to send your only begotten Son to die on a cross for us. So we give you the thanks and the praise right now, Father, for all that you have done for us. You've created the heavens and the earth, and you made us for your purposes, Lord God. So we humbly come before you, Lord God, and we say, Lord, here we are, Lord God. Work through us, Lord God, and have your way in our lives, Father God. In order for that to happen, Father, we know, Lord God, that you need to break addictions off the lives of your people, Lord God. Whatever it is that they may be addicted to that is hindering your work from being done in their lives, Father God, I pray, Father God, that you will break that addiction, that stronghold, that habit that is keeping them from fulfilling your purpose for them, Lord God. I pray that you will break it off their lives now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father God, I thank you, Lord, that you've given them strength to resist the devil once they submit to you, Lord God, and he will flee. And I thank you, Lord God, that you will give them eyes to see the way of escape out of every temptation, Lord God. And I thank you that you are faithful, Lord God, not to allow them to be tempted more than they can bear, Lord God. So the temptation that they may face because of this addiction, Lord God, they already can overcome it, Lord God, because you allowed it to come into their lives, Lord God, and help them to see the way of escape, Lord God, as they look to you, Lord God, as their deliverer and the one who saves them out of every temptation, Father God. And I pray, Lord God, that even the practical things with regards to who we connect ourselves to and associate ourselves to, Lord God, help us, Lord God, not to be around bad company, Lord God, that will keep us bound in addictive behaviors, Lord God, because your word says that bad company corrupts good character, Lord God. So help us to surround us with the right people that will encourage us, build us up, and strengthen us, Lord God, spiritually, that we will grow and accomplish your purposes that you have for us, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord, that even as every single day passes by, that we will spend a moment even in your word, Lord God, meditating on your word, listening to your Holy Spirit, and planting your word in our hearts, Lord God, that when the temptation comes, Lord God, that we will be able to act as Jesus did when he was tempted and use the word of God to defend ourselves and to resist the temptation, to do warfare against the enemy, that we will say, "It is written," and use the word of God to be victorious over any temptation or any addictive behavior when the pressure comes upon our flesh to submit to that thing, Lord God. And I pray, Father God, that you will give us discernment, Lord God, and help us to use wisdom, Lord God, not to go into situations where we will more than likely be tempted to sin, Lord God. Help us, Lord God, direct our paths, I pray, Father God. And I ask, Lord God, that on a regular daily basis that you fill your children, Lord God. Fill us with the power of your Holy Spirit till we are full and overflowing, that we will be a vessel to touch other people, Lord God. That once we are filled, Lord God, that there'll be no room for the enemy to take residence in our hearts, Lord God. That we, Lord God, will be able to overcome every single addiction, Lord God, and be victorious, Lord God, in our battle against sin, temptation, and every single negative addiction, Father. I commit every single person listening to you, Lord God. I cover them with the blood of Jesus, and I pray your perfect will be accomplished in their lives, Lord God. I thank you. We give you the praise and the glory, Lord God, and I thank you that you've called every single person listening right now to the sound of my voice an overcomer by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony, and that they're not afraid to lose their lives, Lord God, but they submit their lives unto you, and that you will get glory through their lives, Lord God, as they go from glory to glory and from strength to strength. So I commit every single person listening right now to your hands, Lord God, for their victory, Lord God, over every single addiction. And I thank you, I honor you, and I commit them into your hands. In Jesus' name, I thank you and I pray. Amen. So that's it for this episode of the Faith Fight podcast. I hope that you are blessed. This is an extremely, extremely important topic that I covered today, overcoming addictions. We all struggle with something and we all need people as well. So if you are not planted in a church right now, if you do not have the support of spiritual guidance, I'm going to encourage you to find a church. If you don't know in your area where there is a good church who teaches the Bible, you can reach out to me and email me, and I'll try my best to help find you a church that you can be planted in, where they have good life groups, where you can connect with other Christian believers, learn how to study the Bible for yourself, learn how to be accountable to them as you go through life, and grow and mature as a Christian and become all God has intended you to be, email me if you don't know anyone in your area and I will help you find them. My email address is me@chriscrary.com, C-H-R-I-S-C-R-E-A-R-Y. That's me@chriscrary.com, and I will help you find the church. Again, I've prepared notes and the Bible verses and a customized prayer plan for overcoming addictions for you. You can download that by clicking the link in the description, enter in your email address, and then it will be sent to you in an email. And you can use that for your daily devotions to help you and encourage you as you fight overcoming the addiction and as you live victoriously. So there's a link in the description for that. And remember to subscribe. Remember to share this with someone else to help them break their addictions that they may have, and continue to do great things because God is with you and He has empowered you to do wonderful things today. So that's all I have to say. Remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you will hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight podcast. Be blessed, everyone.